Tom Michel, are you going to improvise during the nightmare sequence? Because he needs some music when he shows the set.
Well, anyway.
You must just
play the theme. You can play a little of the theme, like the riff.
Yes, of course.
Well, nobody else knows it.
Now?
For many of us who thought Les Miserables would never end, a lot of us thought Miss Saigon would never begin. But looking around this room, I can't imagine that we could have ever assembled such a brilliant, wonderful, talented company as you are, and we are all delighted that you are here. And whatever the public may make of Miss Saigon, I know this is going to be a great adventure for all of us. All I can say is I'm thrilled to have you, and I'm thrilled that I can now go away for at least 8 weeks and leave the show in the wonderful hands of Nick Heitner and Bob Avian. Thank you all.
I can only echo what Cameron said. And also, I would like to say that we, all of us who put this show together, feel particularly thrilled and honoured that our company includes so many people who are from outside of this country.
I'm Pinky, and I'm from where? I'm from the Philippines. Pinky Amador to English people. Pinky Amador to the Philippines.
I'm Monique. And I'm 19. I'm from the Philippines also.
Dreadful to bits. I'm sure this is probably what they do in prison when they bring in the new... I am the chief warder and my name is Heitner, so...
My name is Dominique. I come from Paris. And that's all. I am very happy to see with you, to be here.
It really started one day when Claude Michel saw a picture in the newspaper, which was a picture of a woman which was giving her child to a pilot, an American pilot, in Tan Son Nhat Airport, which is Saigon's airport, and giving that child, you know, both of them were crying, and she just wanted to give the child for the child to have a future. And the immediate words that came to our mind seeing that picture was the ultimate sacrifice, because that's really, I think, the ultimate sacrifice a human being can do, not see your child again in order to give your child a future that you will never have yourself. And from a long time, Claude Michel and I had been discussing the idea of Madame Butterfly, you know, that there was something there that we wanted to modernize, to rework. And suddenly, that image made the idea of Miss Saigon.
Because, of course, Madame Butterfly is not a Puccini story, you imagine, it's a play. It's a play, and the origin of the play is a French book by Pierre Loti.
We are not trying to make a musical about the Vietnam War like the movies which have been made about the Vietnam War. It's a tragic love story which has the Vietnam War as a background, or at least the very end of the Vietnam War. I'm sure Richard Maltby, who has been working with me on the English lyrics for 2 years now, would like to add something to all that.
America had never lost a war. And this, we still thought John Wayne was going to come over the hill and save the day. There was something dying for America, much bigger than just the end of an event or a war that they had officially pulled out of 2 years before. This was the end of a vision of America, of a dream of America, of its invincibility and of the perfect morality that we clothe ourselves in all the time. It came to an end brutally on that day. So this moment in time that's part of the background of this love story has a reverberation in American history that just needs to be, you know, pointed out from time to time.
That's all, I think.
Okay, thank you.
These two pieces slide off, and the bar itself slides down into position, which as they're doing that, I'll just run through the... everything happens... then it glides magically. And in the next scene, you're in the bar. There are a lot of American customers, a few individual Marines have individual lines. They're all talking about the girls, about who they're going to bed tonight. We see the girls themselves dreaming of a life in America. One of the girls wins the Miss Saigon contest, And another of the girls, Kim, who is going to be the central character, is bought for Chris by his friend John. And that all happens in this scene. So there, and there it is, as you see, these pieces all slide from different directions and meet magically together.
The girls come on the stage. See my bikini, it's just the right size.
Don't you enjoy it how it
rides up my thighs?
Look from behind, it'll knock out your eyes. I'll show you my special trophy of war. For a marina show more. You won't get up off the floor, the heat is on in Saigon. Don't tell me I'm reassigned, all that chicken shit sucks. Tonight I'm out of my mind, not to mention $10.
To imagine, just for the sake of your entrance, is that there's buildings going up here, this going up here and also up here, and there's a street here, and then there is a street at the back that you have to walk across and then come down. So that what we need is first of all it's Leia, then it's Janine, and she's coming this way, and as she comes this way she sees Isai coming down this way. Okay, so you wait, you say hello to each other, and then you both of you come down. And just brush past, don't ignore Leia. And so you're coming down, and you're coming down here. And then when you come down to here, this hasn't come on yet. Your walls haven't come on yet. Go.
Now, Ali, where does it take all day? Get to your house as well, because I think.
Oh, I need to
go and
something actually.
Yeah.
I'm here.
That one's okay, that one sort of pulls back in.
Oh, it does, it? Does it?
Well, there's no row, but it just gets quieter, which gives the impression.
So you're holding it like this, everybody. No, don't put your finger in the trigger. No, you've got this part of the gun. This will be up. Very good. All right, from the top with the chain gang.
On silent feet it came, breathing a sheet of flame.
You must now start thinking about the words you're singing, because they're good, strong words. You're talking about your army, the North Vietnamese army. On silent feet it came, breathing a sheet of flame it came. It's a great image. You must use that. Closing in on its rightful prey, burning 100 years away, truth lit up the street. You've heard this sort of stuff. You've heard any number of crackpot politicians banging this out, and you're singing it like wimps at the moment, and you really got to give it balls.
On silent feet it came, breathing a sheet of flame. It came, closing in on its rightful prey, burning 100
7, and up, 2, 3, 4, and exit. All right, I'll fix that in the theater. Okay.
At the end of this is the hour, this is the land. You make your exit, and we'll do that in a minute, to the side that you re-enter from, because you then have a very quick change. All right? Now, are you blokes, none of you, involved in this? You're not. So is Johnny the only person who's not involved? Michael, I know, is Johnny the only person not involved in this? That's a shame. Oh, you weren't? Right, fine. So what's this unit? What's this unit? Your bicycles. This unit is... Oh yeah, you're next to Andrew with a gun. You jog on with them, you'll see what to do. You can see him. Right, okay.
To pay for my keep, I'm rounding up sheep to fleece here in Bangkok. I'm disgraced. I can't get ahead, cause nothing is dead as peace here in Bangkok. Yeah, yeah. 10 cents an hour and I stand all day. Yo, yo, yo. Once more, same place. 5, 6, 7, and go. 1, 2, 3. Ba da ba da ba da cha. Men coming on, and 5, 6, 7, and hit. And center. 6, 7, 8. Okay, okay, ladies, you're not in the right spot. 5, 6, 7, 8.
It's Kim's room number 4. She's coming up. Extras wise. Side gauzes almost finished. This is Dreamland. Showing the textures that John would like. Right down to the beer wise.
Yeah, you were late, you were late, you were late. Because what we're aiming for here, which is beginning to come together, is you get this sense of total driving panic, but every beat of the story comes through. And that's the challenge, is to discipline chaos in such a way that you do see chaos, but you also see every beat of the story coming through, is an achievement. And this is what we're on the way to doing. Right, now, I'm going to run it through now.
I'm the wife of a soldier, please let me through. Help me, homeless, die, pay, tell me what I...
Why don't we go for it? Why don't we go for it? Why don't we go for it? I mean, just this might end up sounding like Rossini or something, but we just have to. I'm going to give you a wail every time, okay?